When this disease started spreading, it was reported that those 65 and older were the most at risk. To protect ourselves, we were advised to remain at home, basically quarantine. Being retired, we were already living off of our pensions and savings, so our main concern was access to the items necessary to satisfy our physiological needs: safety, security, food, and medicine. In regards to safety and security, I ensured that all car doors were locked, all motion detectors were working properly, all exterior lights were working, deadbolts locked, and security systems were operational. I'm not a prepper, but I do believe some will resort to criminal activity if this lockdown continues too long. No one wants to be in a situation where they need to defend themselves with a weapon. However, in the military we had a saying, better to have it and not need it, than to need it and not have it. If the time ever comes when you need it, the last thing you want is a malfunction. Therefore, I took the time to clean all of our weapons to ensure that they operated and functioned properly. The online shopping services were great, and Sharon never needed to leave the house. She ordered all of our groceries and medicine online, and they were delivered to our front door. All we had to do was bring them inside and stow them. We didn't always get what we requested. The only thing more difficult to find than toilet paper was ammunition. Of course, on occasion we would do takeout. Thanks to the internet, Sharon was able to order most of the items we needed and even reconcile her bank statements online. Priorities resolved, we attempted to escape the boredom by diving into our hobbies. Sharon organized and reorganized the materials for her crafts, which was necessary because the house was beginning to look like a floral shop. She occupied her time by binge-watching her favorite series on TV and working on her crafts. As for myself, well, I had plenty of time to perform maintenance on our vehicles. I used the time to do small things that I would normally pay someone else to do. I even ordered materials online. I had them delivered to build some of the projects that I had been delaying for months. Some chores really weren't chores. I guess you could call it sanity maintenance with benefits. It's a way to distract yourself and accomplish something at the same time. And what a better time to polish something up for a nice tranquil ride in the future. Hopefully, the near future. Both of us were creative in discovering ways to distract ourselves from this pandemic. At the same time, you can't allow yourself to become complacent to the situation. Criminals are being released from prisons in an attempt to avoid widespread breakouts of this disease. What genius came up with that idea? That's all we need. More criminals on the streets at a time like this, when they can't possibly find a job. And these geniuses are dumbfounded when the criminals they've released immediately start committing crimes. It's times like this that requires you to take that extra caution. If a motion detector is triggered, by all means check it out, but do so with protection. I haven't felt the need to carry a weapon everywhere since my deployments to Iraq and Afghanistan. Now, it's never more than one step away, kind of like that credit card commercial. Never leave home without it. Dwelling on gloom and doom can drive anyone crazy. Sometimes a good puzzle can help you escape and free your mind, even if only temporarily. It can't be that difficult. aren't you special? Unfortunately, there are days when doom and gloom can bring on momentary depression. I love the sun, I love the outdoors, and I love being on the water. Days like this seem to zap all the energy right out of me. When it's raining, your activities are basically limited to doing house chores, watching TV, or reading a book. When you're really bored, talking to an old friend could help. On the other hand, attempting a meaningful conversation can be a challenge in itself when you're depressed and cranky. Yeah, what do you want?
Hey, butt wipe.
Hey, butt lick.
Hey, I heard your neighborhood beautification committee was giving you an award for putting a mask over your butt face.
I heard you and your wife went for a walk without mask, and she got a fine for walking her dog without a muzzle.
Well, I heard that they're standing you up in front of toilet paper displays to scare away crowds.
I heard you don't have any toilet paper because you've been using it to wipe your butt face.
Well, I heard that when people see a face like yours, they try to flush it.
I hear you've been walking around without a mask, scaring all the crap back into people.
Well, I heard you're actually trying to help with the epidemic. When people see your ugly face, they have a strong desire to be alone.
I hear that you're helping the state police, standing on the state line with no mask, stopping all the traffic and scaring everyone away.
Well, I heard that the ugly police are locking your doors from the outside.
Why'd you call me Butler? What do you want?
I just wanted to know if you're okay.
Look, I gotta sanitize my ear. Later, dipwad.
Well, don't butt face down me again.
You called me. Asshole. Some evenings, I sit outside attempting to rationalize this pandemic. Unfortunately, the answers aren't there. The news agencies have become so politically biased that they are no longer trustworthy. What about the CDC? Are any of the precautions they recommend really effective? They flood you with statistics on new infections and death. What about those who have recovered from it? Why aren't those numbers reported daily? Then there are the conspiracy theories, which I tend to give more credibility every day. In politics, it's common practice to never let a crisis go to waste. Is this just a trial run to see how many of our liberties the government can take away? Some states have handled this pandemic wisely, some not. It may be wise to make a mental note of that. What about reopening? Are states opening too early? Are precautions in place? What is the next phase? Watch Sweden. They appear to be the model for handling this pandemic. I support states reopening for business. There are many in the younger generations who need to work to pay their debts and provide for their families. If we don't feel safe going out, we won't. We will just carry on as we have until that time comes. I can't think of a better way to temporarily escape the confinement of a quarantine than getting out on the boat and catching some rays. I always enjoy a trip to Tampa to check out new developments on the waterfront. And of course, an added attraction are the yachts. With today's technology and engineering, they're no longer just functional yachts. They're floating pieces of art. After a few passes, it's time to head back home. Maybe open it up a little bit. When I'm out in the water, I always hate to see the day end, but today is exactly what the doctor ordered. Days like today serve as a reminder of the way things once were and provide hope that someday soon we can return to normal. I embrace that hope, and with that thought, perhaps I'll give an old friend a call, let him know someone is thinking about him, maybe provide him with hope for the future, and perhaps apologize for being an asshole.